Thank you. Let me say also my words of welcome to Ambassador Vladimir Vinokurov, who is the ambassador of the Russian Federation to the Commonwealth of Dominica, to Ambassador Hubert Charles, Special Advisor to the Minister of Foreign Affairs, Mr. Nuri Kat, Special Advisor, the PS in the Ministry of Foreign Affairs, the staff of the Ministry of Foreign Affairs. Welcome, Ambassador, and your team to Dominica. We are very pleased to be able to welcome you here. Of course, following the disaster caused by Hurricane Maria in September 2017, we were pleased to have the support of the Russian Federation. It is good for us to be able to have our friends and partners assist us at times like this when we suffer from disasters and the ill effects of disasters. Of course, the Russian Federation is a good friend of Dominica. We have had diplomatic relations with the Russian Federation since 1995. Following the disaster of Hurricane Maria, the Russian Federation, through its embassy, got in touch with the Commonwealth of Dominica. They wanted to offer a helping hand to see how they could assist Dominica to address the challenges that are facing us as a result of Hurricane Maria. They decided, notwithstanding the far distance of Russia, they decided that they would send to us humanitarian relief and support for our reconstruction efforts. So today we have this ceremony to acknowledge and to thank the Russian Federation and the ambassador and his team for making this donation to Dominica. This donation, as the ambassador has indicated, includes mobile units, it includes galvanized flooring, it includes plywood, it includes also relief supplies. And we also will be receiving another shipment very soon of additional relief supplies. Ambassador, of course, it's a very challenging time for us in Dominica. We have a lot of people who have lost their homes as a result of the storm. A lot of people have suffered damage to their homes. There are persons who have lost their jobs, who have lost their businesses. And of course, there is massive infrastructural damage that has been caused to Dominica, our schools, our roads, our bridges, public buildings. And so it's going to be a long, hard road of recovery for Dominica. And we are thankful that we know that we have partners like the Russian Federation that are standing with us as we face this reconstruction and rebuilding process. As you may know, the Honorable Prime Minister has indicated that he wants Dominica to become the first climate resilient nation in the world. And of course, for that to happen, we have to ensure that we have not only the best minds working with us to ensure that we build infrastructure that is more climate resilient, but we also need the support of our friends and partners in the international community so that we are able to realize the goal to make Dominica climate resilient. Of course, we know that climate change is real. We are experiencing the effects of climate change, and we have to adapt and put in place mitigating measures to address the challenges that we will face as climate change continues. And so it's very important for us to know that we have the support of our friends in the international community, and more particularly the Russian Federation. We look forward to concluding a number of agreements with Russia, hopefully in the not too distant future, that will help strengthen the people-to-people contact between our two nations and also our trade and economic ties. So we thank you very much, Ambassador, for being with us today. We also thank the representative. There's also a representative from EMACON, and let me make sure that I get this correctly. EMACON is the Agency for Support and Coordination of Russian Participation in International Humanitarian Operations. And there's a gentleman who is with us since Monday, and he will be here until the 17th. And there is also another gentleman from EMACON who will come here on the 20th. So we see that the Russian Federation is certainly showing their solidarity and support for Dominica, and we are very grateful to them. And we thank you, Ambassador, once again. Thank you.